I'm Tracy Bankston with today's Record News Watch. Police agencies throughout the region are a part of the intense manhunt for the person or persons who ambushed a pair of Pennsylvania state police officers in Pike County Friday night, killing one and wounding the other. It happened outside the state police barracks in Blooming Grove Township in a rural wooded area off Interstate 84 and Route 402. Corporal Brian Dixon was killed and Trooper Alex Douglas was wounded. Investigators do not believe the attack or attackers stayed in the area. Now that belief has put a neighboring agencies on high alert, including New York State police officers based here across the border in Orange and Sullivan counties.
All the troopers are on a heightened alert. Anything that the Pennsylvania State Police need, any of our resources are available to them whenever they need.
And talk to me about the fact that this has got to hit home, because this is a fallen comrade, even though it's across state lines.
It does hit home. The Blooming Grove barracks are right across the border from us, and all troopers nationwide, especially Pennsylvania, we share a brotherhood with all of them, and it's so close to home that it hit all the guys really hard.
Corporal Dixon leaves behind his wife, Tiffany. They'd celebrated their 10th wedding anniversary last month. Pennsylvania Crime Stoppers has increased the reward money to $50,000 for information that leads to an arrest. A pile of debris is all that's left of a major section of a residence that was destroyed by a fire Sunday afternoon in Goshen. Three people, a man and two women, were in the house at number 2 Avalon Drive when the fire broke out. They were able to get out safely. Elmer Budd is the Goshen fire chief.
You could see the plume of smoke from in the village from where I live. We immediately called for a second alarm even before we got here. And then when we did get here, we called for a third alarm for our water supply, because we have to tank all our water in here. There's not a hydranted area. The building was basically fully involved, everything to the left side, everything except for the garage area. With the first, second floor, the attic was just flaming. Our initial thing was a defensive fire attack to try to knock some of the flames down until we established a water supply. And once we got the water supply established with our tankers and so forth, then we had people go into the garage area, and they cut the fire off there so that the garage, as you can see, is still standing.
Close to 100 firefighters from a dozen area companies were called to the scene. Members of Orange County's Fire Investigations Unit have begun the search for the cause of the 3-alarm blaze. Investigators in Ulster County had said Jason Marichaux set fire to a barn in the outskirts of the town of Woodstock back in June 2010 as a way to create a diversion while he robbed a Bank of America branch in the center of town about 15 minutes after setting the blaze using a stolen car during the course of the events. A 32-year-old former Woodstock resident eluded police, and his name and photo was put on the Ulster County Sheriff's Department top 10 most wanted list. But law enforcement recently got a tip that Marichaux was living in Eugene, Oregon, and he was arrested Sunday and will face charges of robbery, arson, and grand larceny when he's returned to Ulster County. According to a local Oregon TV station, Marichaux was taken into custody while he was playing in an ultimate frisbee tournament. Felony charges have been filed against a Kingston woman who was accused of stealing more than $16,000 worth of unemployment benefits. 56-year-old Betty Anderson McComb was charged with grand larceny, offering a false instrument for filing, and falsifying business records. Authorities say she received unemployment benefits that she was not entitled to. Anderson McComb was arrested following a joint investigation by state police and the State Department of Labor. Ulster County Sheriff's deputies have charged a Slade Hill man with criminal mischief after they say he was spotted in his pickup truck Friday evening doing donuts in the grass field on the property of the Accord Speedway. Police say 53-year-old Raymond Ott caused damage to the landscaping on the Speedway property. He was released pending a September 24th appearance in town of Rochester court. When Ulster County Sheriff's deputies responded to a reported accident early Saturday morning on Route 28 in the town of Hurley, they discovered a man hiding inside the trunk of a vehicle. And police say a further investigation determined that 22-year-old Eric Allen had tried to hide because he had violated his parole. The 22-year-old Kingston man was taken into custody without incident and charged by sheriff's deputies with obstructing governmental administration. He was sent to Ulster County Jail following his arraignment in town of Hurley Court. And 13 of New York City's top graffiti artists put their talents on display in Kingston Saturday using their favorite medium, a subway train car. This was a graffiti art event called The Burning of Kingston, held at Kingston's Trolley Museum. Artists expressed themselves on some of the subway cars housed at the museum. Visitors got the chance to check out the paints and brushes used by graffiti painters. It's an art form that was in its heyday back in the 1970s and 80s. The historical theme of the burning of Kingston was tied into the graffiti exhibition. Participating artists were hoping the Kingston event brings a greater awareness to this unique art form that's been used as a way for people to express themselves and their culture. It shouldn't be as chilly when you head out tomorrow morning, but it'll probably be rainy. The Tuesday forecast includes showers in the morning with clearing skies by afternoon. Temperatures Tuesday should be up around 70 degrees. Wednesday will be sunny and pleasant with the highs in the lower 70s. We'll get an edge on the day by starting it with the Times Herald Record and keep clicking here at Record Online throughout the day to stay on top of breaking news. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter. We'll be right back.